Hello, welcome to the Dental Learning Center. I'm Dr. Junior Poser, with my fellow host, Dr. Marie Hoogie, and our special guest, Dr. Homer Goon. Today we'll be talking about the framework design for the porcelain fused to metal restoration. I hope you'll tune in and enjoy this presentation.
Excellence in Dentistry, Junior. Excellence in Dentistry.
Framework design for the porcelain veneered restoration ideally provides for an even thickness as well as support for the veneering material. In addition, there are still indications for the ceramo-metal restoration. Partial denture abutments, crowns with attachments, and long span bridge abutments are some of these uses. It is the responsibility of the dentist to ultimately select the restorative material. And while the dentist is unlikely to actually fabricate the restoration, understanding framework design is an important aspect when communicating with the dental laboratory and diagnosing problems. Above all, it is important to be able to address patient concerns with honest, knowledgeable answers that can come only from an intimate understanding of the process. Today we're going to concentrate on the design of the single porcelain fused to metal restoration. The porcelain fused to metal restoration consists of a combination of metal coping and porcelain. The coping covers the entire preparation, gives strength to the restoration. The porcelain is fused to the coping for aesthetics and may be limited to the facial surface of the metal or extend over the entire coping. The illustration shows a cross-section of the restoration on an anterior tooth. The enlarged section illustrates the various components of the restoration and the optimal thickness of each component. Decreasing the thickness of the metal may cause flexibility in the coping, which may lead to subsequent fracture of the porcelain facing when stress is applied to the restoration. The opaque porcelain layer must be approximately 2/10 millimeter thick to prevent the underlying metal from affecting the desired shade of the porcelain. The body porcelain must be at least 7/10 millimeter thick to obtain a true shade for the facing. The thickness and length of the incisal porcelain may vary according to the degree of translucency desired. This diagram illustrates a design for full coverage occlusal porcelain. The gingival margin here remains in metal. Areas of extra bulk in the coping are provided to support the contact area. This type of restoration is useful in areas where aesthetics are not the primary concern.
The external ceramic metal interface has a distinct finish line of approximately 90 degrees. This provides for a strong, smooth junction. Internal line angles are rounded. The veneering material should be supported by the substructure. In general, porcelain should not be extended over 2 millimeters. Extending the framework to support the veneering material will better resist fracture. The metal framework must provide support for the incisal edge. Overreduction of the tooth at the incisal edge and failure to extend the coping weakens the porcelain and invites failure.
The design of the framework for anterior porcelain fused to metal restorations should provide adequate space for porcelain in the contact area. The light should be able to be transmitted through the contact. Extension of full thickness metal into the contact areas may block the transmission of light in these areas and affect the aesthetic appearance of the porcelain facing.
In this illustration, the framework designed for the maxillary cuspid should include porcelain at both contact areas. The metal-to-porcelain junction should be located 1 mm lingual to the contact area TP, permit light transmission through the contacts. The design for the PFM on the mandibular second premolar is shown. Provision is made for buccal coverage porcelain with porcelain contact on the mesial, and metal contact on the distal. Extension of the metal provides strength to the porcelain. Alternatively, the porcelain may be extended over the occlusal surface.
Every effort should be made to design the framework for the anterior PFM restoration in such a manner that the occlusal centric stop will be located in an area of full thickness metal. Alternatively, it may be located in an area of porcelain, highly glazed porcelain, but never should it be at the junction of the porcelain and metal, if at all possible. It may also be possible to place a metal-centric stop in the area of the occlusal contact.
The thickness of veneering porcelain should be approximately 1 mm thick. One can easily make a cutback tool from an old instrument, as shown in the diagram, to produce a coping of the appropriate dimension. To accomplish this by hand, first wax the die to a full contour crown. Then, outline the area of the cutback. Using the custom-made instrument, remove the appropriate wax thickness. The coping should provide for a minimum of 0.3 mm thickness, rounded internal line angles, and extended to support the veneering porcelain. In cases where a brut porcelain margin is desired, a 1 mm labial shoulder with a 90-degree internal line angle is used. The metal coping is cut back, and porcelain is used to form the crown margin. While excellent aesthetics is possible, this method requires a high degree of expertise to accomplish.